Welcome to ENT student. Now we are going to demonstrate how the light source is being kept. So Negus is the proximal and Jackson is the distal one. Now we are inserting the light source into this esophagoscope, pediatric esophagoscope. So you should be having this in your left hand like this or right hand, whatever it is initially. But once you connect this to this cold light source here, you have to insert it like this and check whether it is functioning or not. So keep it in your left hand and put it in your in between your fingers. This acts like a esophagus or whatever it is. So it you have to check it like this. You are able to see it here inside. Yes, show the lumen, focus sir. On it and show yes. It, keep it nearby.
Yes.
Okay, you are able to see the lumen and then that way you can examine the things that are there. So what is the technique that you want to see? So now you could see the light source, that is, whether it is a perfect light source, it should be round. And this bevel whatever is there, it should be going towards the thinner part. So for example, if you want to see the pyriform, for example, how would you do the esophagoscopy? Means the patient has to be kept in a supine position like this, okay, with almost 10 centimeters, just a minimal amount of extension with the pillow below the neck, and then once you put your hand like this, so this is the esophagus. For example, I have to reach this esophagus. Initially patient will have mouth like this, so you have to open the mouth and then put gauze pieces this side and go on to the tongue till the level of your vallecula. So if you go till this is the level of your tongue, for example, so vallecula, and as you could see, so if you see like this, so this will become your show from there. So this will be median glossal epiglottic pore, this is the lateral glossal epiglottic pore. So once you reach there, you reach the vallecula over here and then you reach till the level of your larynx. This becomes your larynx. You can see the larynx. So lateral to the larynx, because the patient is already intubated, lateral to the larynx you find the piriform fossa. Just you touch the mucosa of the piriform fossa, it opens. It opens, 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 and then one point you find the way into the esophagus. So once you go into the esophagus, so what you have to do is you have to adjust your position accordingly to this side or that side, and carefully. You should be very careful and not damage any mucosa inside, and you should examine slowly, slowly you should dip inside. Dip inside and go till the level of your, dip inside and go till the level of your esophagus. So this is how you have to go till the level of esophagus, not damaging any of the structures, not damaging any of the structures. And if there is any, for example, if there is any foreign body, if there is any secretions inside, you have to do suction like this. Suction will be done like this, and then later on, you find a foreign body, slowly you have to insert this, you have to show this, you have to insert this, forceps inside, and by vision, place a 1 rupee coin over there, and by vision, place a pen. Okay, we are going to see this particular, this is the foreign body for example, under vision you have to see that and hold it like this and get it till the level of this one, and then slowly, of course, this is not a coin, and just oversimplifying the things, use it. So you have to pull both at a time. This is the railroad technique that you have to remove the foreign body. Until the foreign body is removed, you should not show it to the attendants. Be careful during that. So after that, secretion, suction you have to do, and then hand it over to the anesthetist for further action. Okay. The chances here are damage of mucosa, damage of teeth, damage of any bleeding inside, damage of any tumors that are there. Tumors that are there, that can be there, you can lead to hemorrhage, and there can be mediastinitis, etc., etc. What are all the complications of esophagoscopy possible that will occur? Okay. Thank you very much for watching, ENT student, about a basic video about the esophagoscopy.